Welcome to Powered by Snowflake, a series where I interview technology leaders building applications and businesses on Snowflake. I'm your host, Daniel Myers, and today I'm talking with Abhishek Rai, co-founder and chief architect at NetSpring. NetSpring is a product analytic platform powered by Snowflake. Abhishek, how are you today?
I'm great, Daniel. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well, and I'm excited to talk to you all about NetSpring and how you've built this product analytic platform powered by Snowflake. So in your own words, tell me, what is a product analytic platform and what makes NetSpring so cool?
A product analytics platform, Daniel, is a first-class analytic experience that helps you understand the end user behavior for your own application, a mobile application or a web application. NetSpring is a product analytics platform. The different thing about NetSpring is that we provide product and behavioral analytics in a warehouse native architecture. So we are 100% warehouse native on Snowflake, and our end users can use NetSpring to understand what their own users on their mobile or web platforms are doing with their products. And all of this data ultimately landing in Snowflake and being analyzed through Snowflake by NetSpring.
So tell me more about how you got involved as a co-founder. Tell me the founding story.
Yeah, no, that's great. So before NetSpring, a bunch of us co-founders here at NetSpring, we were previously at ThoughtSpot. And at ThoughtSpot, we were heavy users of some of the leading product analytics tools in the market. And although they filled an important need in the market, we felt that there is a significant disconnect compared to what was possible and what was being offered. And through those experiences and pain points, if you will, we came up with the idea of starting a NetSpring.
So that's pretty interesting. So tell me more about the history of NetSpring, and more specifically, what's the scale of the business today, but also the product?
Yeah, a great question. So NetSpring, we are still an early stage company. We have about a dozen customers. The business is across these customers in different verticals. So we have customers who are in or larger companies, Fortune 100 companies, and then there are several who are medium-sized enterprises. But one common thread that is common across all of these is that they have a large population of users, and you know, they're trying to understand what are modern ways of understanding user behavior and accordingly channel their product investments to better harness that user engagement.
That makes total sense. So tell me, what's a concrete example of how one of your customers has used your platform to make their product better?
One of our customers is a smaller startup that has actually a really textbook case of using product analytics for understanding their user population. So in this case, this customer is Bonfire XYZ. They are a modern crypto-based company where all the data is actually present in Snowflake. In their case, they have data across many different touch points with their customers. They use NetSpring to profile their users, understand what kind of behavioral patterns exist, so they can cross-sell different products to these customers, help move these customers further along in the user retention funnel. Using our product, they're able to better identify areas for investment within their own product.
That is a pretty powerful platform then that you've built, and one that can bring some pretty substantial value to your customers. So from here, tell me more about how it's powered by Snowflake. Do you have an architectural diagram that you can show?
Yes, absolutely. I can show you an architectural diagram. So as you can see here, this is the NetSpring architecture. And at the top is the NetSpring stack. And right underneath, powering our platform, is Snowflake. The NetSpring architecture itself is somewhat similar to what you'd expect from an analytics application. It is running in AWS VPC as shown here. At the top of the stack to the right, you see the term explorations. That's our internal term, or product term rather, for reports. NetSpring supports a wide library of explorations, and you can also build your own. The explorations that our users build, they go through several stages of translation before they reach the SQL compiler layer. The SQL compiler layer is responsible for generating optimal SQL for Snowflake. And this is where we have some of our core IP in understanding user behavior, user journeys, and coming up with the right SQL queries for what the end user or analyst is trying to communicate. The SQL compiler works with the materializer to utilize materialized tables for reusable artifacts. Finally, everything that our platform does end-to-end runs within Snowflake. So all the data for our customers, like the example that I just gave you, all of that arrives from a wide variety of sources into Snowflake. So these could be your Amazon RDS data source, or it could be a product instrumentation data, which is the common case coming from your mobile or web app. It could also be your CRM data, your customer support data, all of that ultimately landing in Snowflake. And that's what we really love about Snowflake. It can be one melting pot for all of these different data sources. And that's where NetSpring really gets its power from, having access to all of that data and being able to push all of that compute down to Snowflake.
So that's pretty beautiful. So it's really interesting to see how, you know, you mentioned Snowflake is the melting pot of data, right? And I love that metaphor because, you know, with Snowflake, it's purpose-built to support structured, semi-structured, and unstructured data. Tell me more about how you leverage all of these different data sources together in Snowflake to get these product insights.
Yeah, that's a great question. So just like you said, Daniel, the kinds of data that our customers bring into Snowflake and access via NetSpring, it covers a huge spectrum. So at one end of the spectrum is semi-structured data. This is primarily data, event data that comes from their instrumentation to their mobile apps or their web apps and stuff. This data is extremely voluminous. In fact, we're working with a customer where they have more than a trillion events in their Snowflake warehouse. And this is a fairly popular mobile app today. And this data, completely unmassaged, lands from their instrumentation layer right in Snowflake. And right from there, it is picked up by NetSpring. We are able to provide self-service analytics on that thanks to the power of Snowflake's performance that scales seamlessly to the variant type to cover JSON data. But even beyond that, to your point, other data sources, our customers routinely bring in Salesforce data through the various integrations offered between Snowflake and Salesforce. They bring in their consumption data from their backend databases. And in all of these cases, what our customers are trying to do is enrich, for example, their product usage analytics by revenue metrics or consumption data to build a more holistic PLG view or product-led growth view of how their users are going through their, let's say, free trial funnel, converting to their platform, how they continue to increase their consumption on the platform, renew, and so on. So really the power of the Snowflake as a data platform for us is to be able to surface insights that cut across these data sources. And with Snowflake, it's just as easy as a click of a button.
I love it. So from here, let's see a real live demo of this in action.
So I'm logged into NetSpring application here. This is our homepage for the NetSpring SaaS application. What you are seeing here are some of the common reporting templates that are used in NetSpring, but there are several more that our library offers. And there are some pre-built dashboards that I have here. For the purpose of this demo, I'm using a synthetic data set that models a demo environment that all of us are familiar with, the Zoom application. So this data set contains information about meetings, accounts, whiteboards, which is a common Zoom feature and something that you'll see more of in this demo. Even though this data set is synthetic, this is all running for real against Snowflake. And in real time, there is data coming from product usage data, from CRM data via Salesforce, all of that landing in Snowflake and accessed from NetSpring. So let's get started with building one of the more common product analytic reports, which is a retention analysis. So I'll go ahead and click on this retention and engagement template. This lands me within the retention template. On the left here, we are seeing the inputs for the retention analysis. On the right, we will get the retention analysis report. This report specifically is tracking retention for users, which is a data set coming from Snowflake, as they interact with the whiteboarding feature in Zoom. Now, I don't know if you've used this feature, but this is something that I absolutely love about Zoom, the whiteboarding feature. And what we are trying to model here is retention for users as they interact with the whiteboarding feature. And this could be something that a product analyst or a product manager might care about as they attempt to identify areas for investment for this whiteboarding feature that they might be developing. So I'll go ahead and select the time frame for this retention analysis for 2 weeks, and let's run the report. So we're seeing a fairly straightforward EK curve for the retention analysis here. And what we are seeing is that in the 2 week time frame, retention is dropping to just under 10% for this data set. And perhaps as product manager or stakeholder, that's something I care about. Now, what our users have told us time and again across different verticals is that while your users are engaged within the first 2 weeks, for example, here, there might be certain actions that you might want to nudge your users towards. And users who activate via those actions, they are much more likely to retain. So one of the common patterns with a retention analysis is to identify what are these actions or behaviors which are indicative of future retention. And that's what you can do right here in NetSpring with just a click of few buttons, all live against Snowflake. In order to do that, I'll access the segmentation section here, and I will go ahead and use an existing cohort that I've built on this user population. So I'll go ahead and click on Add Collection and select one of the existing collections. The collection that I will use for this analysis is a set of users who I believe are already activated on this feature, the whiteboards feature. So we'll go ahead and click that. As a baseline, I will bring in the set of all users that's shown as all actors here. Actors in NetSpring are any entity who take actions on a platform, effectively entities who take certain behavioral steps. And finally, I will bring in as a North Star, the set of power users. And we'll run the report with that. And meanwhile, I'll just show you the definition for who these users are. So I've now switched to the definition for the activated users on NetSpring. So this is self-service way of defining the set of users who, as a product manager, I might consider as activated on our platform. And this is effectively the set of users who either go through this funnel of activity or this other funnel, so indicated by this OR here. Now, as you can see, the behavior that I'm describing here for building this user cohort, it's actually fairly sophisticated behavior where we are tracking this inline funnel on a per user basis and then selecting all of this user population on the fly, all happening live against Snowflake. Coming back to our retention analysis here, we can see that this pink chart here, which shows the set of users who are activated, they are retaining way better than our baseline user population. So clearly, as a product stakeholder, it tells me that while I have my users' interest, if I have time to nudge them along further in the product journey, and if they were to, let's say, get to these actions that I relate to activation, then they are likely to retain much better on our platform. And similar to that, there is this power users cohort that I've previously defined, which covers users who have several repeat actions on our platform, and those are clearly retaining way better on our platform. I will now segue into a slightly different part of our product. Of course, a lot of the analysis that you do in a platform like NetSpring, you want to socialize with your team and share it with the wider audience. So NetSpring contains a fairly sophisticated dashboarding layer as well. So I'll now switch to our dashboarding layer. So this, we are looking at a dashboard that I've previously built for the whiteboards feature here. And within this dashboard, there are a variety of different visualizations that I've added to help add color to different kinds of behavior that our users are having on this whiteboarding feature, and which might provide me insights into what might be useful as an area of investment. In fact, one of our really interesting user stories that we learned from one of our customers is that a lot of times building product features is a fairly significant investment for them, whereas through the power of product analytics, something that I'll show you in just a few minutes, they can identify what they refer to as lightweight product interventions. For example, swapping out different screens in their onboarding flow. And a lot of times these lightweight interactions, which come at a fraction of the cost, can have a significant impact on your user retention. And that's really the power of product and behavioral analytics. And we are really fortunate to be doing all of this on Snowflake, something that wasn't available for a lot of other tools in this space when they came up with these experiences several years ago. So for example, over here, we are looking at a funnel chart that shows interaction of users with the whiteboarding feature as they went through different stages. And this is inspired by a real customer experience that we had, where this customer was able to bring in different data sources, specifically marketing data and product usage data. And they were able to identify that certain kinds of behaviors in the product relate strongly to the marketing channel through which they arrived on their platform. And by making some lightweight tweaks to their marketing side and to their product onboarding screens, they were able to significantly boost conversion for their users through the free trial experience.
This is impressive to see. I mean, all of the different things that you can do within this platform and the level of granularity that you have control over, but also the level of visibility that you have into the data. I mean, it's pretty impressive to see.
That's great to hear, Daniel. Thank you.
Tell me more about, over the next 6 to 12 months, what your customers should get most excited about something in your product roadmap.
Yeah, absolutely, Daniel. So in the next 6 to 12 months, we are bringing in several more capabilities around being able to build more sophisticated cohorts of your user population, and then combining these cohorts in more interesting ways. One of our product philosophies is that our analytics tool should be one where any chart that you end up with, like the one I just showed you, it should be a handy starting point for follow-on analysis, right? It's rarely that you get your path-breaking insight in your first report. So we have a significant roadmap plan where we are making our charts more and more interactive. So for example, you can extract a cohort of interest from one population and move it to a different analysis right from there. To your point about data share, several of our customers today use Snowflake data share heavily, and you know that's how they share data with us. And what we've seen out there is Snowflake's data shares are the most scalable, most performant, and you know they offer high level of security. And also you have the choice about enabling it in specific regions, which is important for several of our customers. Now, regarding this ability to go from one report to the other, carry context about user cohorts and stuff, it matters to our customers that they're able to run these analysis across what are traditionally different islands of data. For example, marketing touchpoints, product interactions, customer support, renewals, etc. And through the ease of use that Snowflake data shares offer, they are able to seamlessly, with just click of a button, share these different data sources with NetSpring so that we can help them derive insights across these data sources.
So Abhishek, where should people go to learn more about you or about the company?
Great question, Daniel. I would say go to our website, netspring.io, and definitely check out our blog. We are actively blogging on that about product, about the industry in general. And also we talk frequently about engineering-centric problems. We've also blogged about why we built it on Snowflake. So absolutely check that out. In addition to that, our team is also fairly active in the user community. We frequently speak at different podcasts, webinars, etc. Please feel free to check us out there.
That sounds great. And I want to say a big thank you for joining me in the studio today. It's been great learning all about NetSpring and how you've built this platform powered by Snowflake.
Thank you so much for having me, Daniel. I love the mission that you guys are on. Thank you.
And to all of our viewers, if you want to learn more about how to build your next application or business on Snowflake, check out developers.snowflake.com. And if you want to see other video interviews like this with tech leaders in the space, subscribe to our YouTube channel. My name is Daniel Myers. This has been another episode of Powered by Snowflake. See you next time.